Hi everyone and welcome to Code of the Future. Last week I did a tutorial on how to play rock, paper, scissors against your own computer. And in that tutorial I used Booleans and the while loop. And I realised that I haven't actually done a video explaining what those are. So that's what today's video is going to be about. I'm going to be talking about Booleans, the while loop, and a little bit more about the if statement as well. So as usual, I'm going to put my glasses on and move you onto the screen. So first I'm going to talk to you a little bit about Booleans and what Booleans are, and then we'll move on to the while loop and then onto the if statement. So the Python data type bool, which apologies I say that quite Yorkshire, but the Python data type bool is used to store two different values, either true or false. And bool is used to test whether a result of an expression is true or false. Like we did in the previous video, we said while true, then we'll run these expressions. So it's essentially either true or false. So we're going to kind of explore this in Python and see kind of the different types of results you get using Booleans. First thing I'm going to do is just write Booleans, just so we know that we're talking about Booleans here. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to say print true, and true has to be with a capital T. So that's something to say about Booleans, they have to be with a capital T for true and a capital F for false, for Python to know that it is a Boolean. So we're going to just print true and run this Python file, and there we go, it says print true. Similarly, we can say, well, let's print true like this. Oh, if I can get my spelling correctly. And we'll print, and it prints true and true. So both of these print statements print true. Now there's a difference between the two types of things we've inputted into our print statement. So what I'm going to say is I'm just going to say print type true, and then I'm going to say print type true like that. So what this is doing is going to return the type of what this is and the type of what this is. So whether it's an integer, a Boolean in this sense, and we're just going to click run. So it tells us the first type here is a bool and the second type here is a string. So these two things are very, very different, and that's just kind of introducing you to what Booleans are and how they differ from just writing true in quotation marks as a string variable. And similarly, we can do the same for false and it will return the same. So what we'll say here is we'll say this type is a bool, and here we'll say this type is a string, just so you can understand the difference between the two. Okay, now I'm going to show you how true and false work in Python. So we're going to say print 5 double equals 5. Now remember, this is saying identically equal to. So when you do one variable, say if we do x equals 5, this is setting the variable to equal 5. So in this case, we have to put a double equals because it essentially means identically equal to. So we're going to click run. Aha, there we go, true. And obviously we know that 5 does equal 5. Whereas let's say, okay, well, does 6 equal 5? And obviously we know the answer to this, false. This is kind of like a nice introduction to how the true and false bools work. So I'm just going to put a comment here and say, testing whether these statements are correct. So whether 5 equals 5 or whether 6 equals 5, which we know is false. I'm going to extend it a little bit further and incorporate the if statement, which I have talked about in a previous video. So we're going to say, incorporating the if statement with a Boolean. Okay, so what I'm going to say is let x equal 10, let y equal to 5. If you're unfamiliar with how to assign variables, I have done a video on my channel, so just check that out if you're unfamiliar. And remember, we have one equals because it's assigning the variable, whereas here we're saying it's identically equal to. So x equals 10 and we're assigning y to equal 5. Now what we're going to say is we're going to say if x mod y double equals 0. Now if you remember from when I did the loop video previously, we came across something similar to this. So what this is saying is if x modulus y, now modulus is when you take x, divide by y, and then return the remainder. So what this is essentially saying is if x divided by y leaves the remainder 0, which we know means it's divisible. So if we have 10 divided by 2, we know that 10 is divisible by 2, so we can say, well, remainder is 0. So that's what this is saying here. We're trying to say, well, let's take two values and let's see if it's divisible. So that's what this first bit means. Then we're going to press enter. Now remember, we always need an indentation for anything that's being run in this statement here. So in this if statement. So if x mod y equals 0, which means it's equal to 0, let's print true. we're going to print true because we know that if the remainder is zero, then yes, we know x is divisible by y. Then we're going to say else, so this means if the first thing isn't true, then we will do this. So we're going to print false because we know it's false if this isn't true. For the kind of convenience of this video, I'm just going to comment these two out here just so that when we run it again, what's coming out of those two print statements won't pop up down here. So there we go, true. So we could say, okay, let's take a prime number, which we know is not divisible by anything. Let's take x equals 11 and we're going to run it. Aha, false. So this is kind of a nice way of showing you how you can use Booleans in if statements. So that's a nice bit of code here, just to show you how Booleans work and how you can incorporate them into an if statement. So that's everything I'm going to talk about on Booleans today. I understand it can get a little bit complicated, especially if you are a beginner. So I'm trying to keep everything at a beginner level, but essentially this is Booleans in Python. That's how they work. And again, how you can incorporate them with an if statement. And if you go back and watch my video that is telling you how to create a rock, paper, scissors game against your own computer, then you'll see that I use the true bool in Python. And then when you watch it, you'll understand a little bit more about why that worked. So now we've talked about Booleans, I'm just going to talk a little bit about the while loop. So we're going to put here, we're going to say while loop. Okay, so we're going to jump straight into it. And I'm going to assign the variable number. Now you can, and for ease of Python, you can simply assign a variable as I. And you'll find when you do more Python and learn a little bit more about Python, you'll see that I and J and K and specific letters are used to assign variables and then use them in a loop. But for the ease of this video, and obviously if you are a beginner, I'm setting it to equal number just so you can kind of understand exactly what's going on. So the first thing I'm going to do is assign number equal to 1. And again, you can write anything you want here. You can write I, J, K, hello, anything. So you can assign anything as a variable. So we start with number equals 1, and then what we're going to say is while, now this is the loop, so while this number is less than 4, and again, because it's a loop, we need a colon at the end. So while number is less than 4, and we enter, and again, we need an indentation within the loop, we're gonna print this number. And then what we're gonna say is if, incorporating the if statement in here, if this number eventually equals 2, which at the moment you may think that's a little bit silly because the number at the moment equals 1, so it's never going to equal 2, but just hang on a sec. So if our number is identically equal to 2, then, and remember the colon, and we've got a new indentation, we're going to break the while loop, okay? And then at the end of here, I'm going to say, let our number equal number plus 1. Okay, so we're going to talk through what this means. So to start with, we have number equals 1. That's what we're assigning our variable to be. Now, what it says is, while this number is less than 4, we're going to print the number. Then, if this number is identically equal to 2, we're going to break this while loop. And then, we're going to say number equals number plus 1. And this is where we start to talk about why this makes sense here. Because we start with number equals 1, and then it's going to do the while loop. And at the end of this while loop, it's going to say the number now equals number plus 1. So we know after one iteration of this while loop, the number will then equal 2. So I'm just going to run this Python file and we're going to see what happens. Okay, here. So we have 1 and 2. So we'll start with number equals 1. And then while this number is less than 4, we know it is less than 4 because it's 1. It will print this number, which is what you can see here. Then it says if number equals equals 2, we'll break the loop, but obviously because we have number equals 1, it isn't equal to 2, so it doesn't break the loop. And then it says number equals number plus 1, so that's where number is being reassigned to 1 in this case, plus 1, which equals 2. So number is now 2, and then it will go back round in the while loop. So while this new number, which is 2, is less than 4, which we know it's less, 2 is less than 4, so it prints this number, which can be seen here. And then it says, if this number is identically equal to 2, which we know it is because we have the new number is 2, then it will break this while loop. So similarly, I could say here, we could change this to 4 and run this. And for a moment, just think about what you think this is going to produce. So we're going to run. Aha, there we go. 1, 2, 3. And the reason why it's done that is because we've chosen number equals 4, but when it eventually gets to number equals 4, the while loop stops running because 4 is not less than 4, because it's equal to 4. So this is kind of a nice little example of how the while loop works. So we can extend this a little bit further, and instead of break we can use continue, which is something that's built in with the while loop. We'll cover it in a future video, but I'm going to put some resources in the description box. Okay, so another thing that we can do, we're going to talk about how you can use else within the while loop. So let's say we have number equals to 2 again, and we're going to say while the number is less than 4, and this is similar to what we did above. So I'm just going to comment down here and just say incorporating the else statement within the while loop. Okay, so while number is less than 4, we're going to say print number, so pretty much identical to what we've done up here. Then we're going to say this bottom line here, so we're going to say print the number, and then we're going to let number equal to number plus 1. Now we're going to say else, and remember the colon and the indentation, we can say else print number is no longer less than 4. Okay, so what this is going to do is it's going to take number equals 2, while 2 is less than 4 it will print 2, then it will say number, the new number is old number, which is 2, plus 1, so our new number will be 3, and it will go through again and again until it gets to a number that is no longer less than 4, in which case it'll print number is no longer less than 4. So we're going to run this Python file and see what happens. I'm just going to drop this up a little bit. Okay, so I'm just going to comment this loop out again here just so we can see exactly what's happening up here. So we're going to run this Python file again. Ah, there we go. So it produces 2, 3, and then number is no longer less than 4, which is what we would expect. Again, like up here when we used this one, when we did eventually put 4 into here, it broke the while loop because 4 was not less than 4. So this is also a nice way of incorporating the else statement within the while loop. And what you'll notice is in Python, loops and statements always come in together. They allow code to be chopped down within, you know, a few lines. And that's what's great about loops, is you don't have to write lines and lines of code. You can just shorten it down quite easy. So that's the while loop. I'm hoping that, you know, you've got a good grasp of how the while loop works. If not, feel free to comment on any of my videos asking for help or clarification. Or reach out to us on social media, the links will be in the description box, and I'm more than happy to answer any questions anybody has. So finally, I'm just going to quickly cover the if statement. I know I have done the if statement in a previous video anyway, but in this video I'm going to talk about the elif statement. So I realised in my previous video I only talked about the if statement and the else statement. So we're going to talk about the elif statement here today. So I'm going to say if statement, I'm going to just put another line here. Okay, so we're going to again assign a variable number equals to, okay, 1. Be adventurous, we'll go with 1. Now we'll say if number is greater than 0, we're going to print positive number, okay? Then we're going to write elif. Now this is a way of saying, or if this is true, then we'll do this. So I'm going to say elif number is identically equal to 0, then we're going to print 0. Then we're going to finish off by saying else, which is what I covered in my previous video on loops. Else and a colon, and remember you need colons after every single one of these statements, as can be seen here. So else print negative number. Okay, and we're just going to run this and see what happens. So our number is obviously 1, so we know it will print positive number. But we can change the round and see, hopefully, that it will do the same no matter what number we put in. Okay, so obviously just ignore all this bit that's all up here, because this is obviously everything else that's been in this Python file. Here, positive number, perfect. So let's do 10, and we know it's a positive number. So it's positive number again, perfect. Let's say minus 10 and click run. Negative number, perfect. And let's say 0. Run, 0. Perfect. So this is a very, very brief way of explaining the elif statement. It's just a really handy way of being able to tell Python to, you know, if this isn't true, then do this, or if this doesn't work, do this. And finally, if all of those things don't work, then do this. So similarly, we could put another elif in here. We could say elif number equals equals 1. We can say print 1. So obviously we've put this here, but we'll have to factor it in here. So we'll just change this to 1 is greater than 1, and we're going to say positive number greater than one. I'm not quite sure why I've done it all in capitals, but anyway, we'll just go with it. So we'll click run, and obviously we know it is zero, but if we were to type one and run it, perfect, it says one. So what I'm trying to tell you is that this elif statement really, really helps. It's just a really handy way of being able to get Python to do things if a certain expression is true or if it's false, you know. In this particular sense, it's a very, very easy example, but it's a really nice way of wrapping your head around how the if, elif, and else statement works. So that is the video. Today we have explored Booleans, the while loop, and a little bit more about the if statement. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, then please like, subscribe, and comment, and I will see you all in the next video.